Hello, this is Kerry Decker, and welcome to another edition of the NightLife Show. Tonight, we're stepping back in time, way back in time, to look at some early film of Teddy Roosevelt and some of the motion picture cameras that were used to photograph him way back at the turn of the century, right here on the NightLife Show. Can't forget that last C, can we? Hi there. How you doing? My name is Kerry Decker, and welcome to another edition of the NightLife Show. NightLife, Central Florida's only television show about television. That's right. And this is kind of the weekly get-together of all the area video files. Almost mispronounced that. Video files. As we get together and get to see what's the latest in home video equipment. Occasionally we talk about some of the old nostalgic TV, and we also have bloopers, outtakes, stuff like that that we sometimes show. Well, tonight we've got something special, and this is what the main part of our program is about. It's going to be about old-time movies and the cameras that photographed some of the old-time movies. But I've got two excellent examples of old-time movie cameras that I thought that maybe you folks out there would enjoy seeing and seeing what it's all about. Now, the first one that I've got away up here. Now, again, I am not expert on these particular cameras. In fact, some of these probably, maybe some of you viewers out there can tell me more about than I have right here. Now, this particular camera is a 35 millimeter movie camera. Now, to some of those folks out there who may not be as initiated into the movie business as others, all of your theatrical movies are shot in 35mm. This is the professional size. Now, when we talk about 35mm, we are talking about the width of film in millimeters. The width of the film is 35mm across. Very wide film. Now, 35mm also, some of you still photographers out there, is what many of the modern SLR-type cameras are take today is 35mm film. Same type of stuff, but this was used originally in movie cameras. In fact, that's how I think the Leica camera and some of the very early ones in the 1920s came about, because there was so much professional motion picture film around that they wanted to shoot some stills from the movies, so they designed a camera that would take the same size film as professional movie film. So that's how we got 35mm. But this is a handheld 35mm movie camera that has to be from about the late 1920s, early 1930s. Let me hold it up near the camera there for you so you can see it. I want you to know, this thing weighs a ton. This is what you look through and crank your home movies. Like that. That's got to be a pain to do that, believe me, as this thing cranks along here. Let me get up a little bit closer to the movie, to the TV camera here, so we can kind of see what we're doing. We'll refocus it a bit. Alrighty. On the side here, this is our standard crank, 16 frames per second. Alrighty, 16 of these movie frames every second is what passes in these particular type of cameras. Or here is the thing where this crank can be taken off and put onto this thing for spring winding. Alright, this is a lock mechanism to hold the crank. Getting out of my frame here. Alright, this will hold the crank down. Alright, and this is our footage counter over here. Now, I'm assuming this goes up to about 20 or so. I have a feeling this is probably meters, since this is a European camera. Now, there was a nameplate on the back here. You can see the spot where the nameplate was, but it's gone. And a lot of these were used for home use. And I tell you, but boy, you sure had to be a muscle man to hold this under any extended period of time. But it was a lot of fun. lot easy to use, and this was all they had. They didn't have video equipment that far back. So, got to rest my arm after that one. Now, we came across another very, very interesting movie camera, which I wanted to show you, which is this one right here. Now, this one also takes 35mm movie film. And this one also is a hand-cranked model. Now, this one's more meant for tripod use. But this one is by the DeVry people. Now, I've heard of them up until the 1940s and 50s. They made a lot of 16mm movie projectors more than anything. D-E, capital V-R-Y. I've heard it pronounced DeVry, and I've pronounced it DeVry. But I don't know which is actually correct on that. But this is the particular movie camera that we're speaking about here. And this one is a hand crank version also, which makes it very nice. Now, what I'm going to do here, let's move in for a close-up. And we'll show you the way this particular camera works, because this one's a honey, I want you to know. And this one's very special in its own way also. Here's, let's move in the camera, okay? This one's kind of in rough shape here, but it has the original finish on it. So let's move into a close-up of that lens. Very small looking lens. And it doesn't say what the focal length or how many millimeter lens it is. Nothing special. Again, black paint. Most of it's worn off. The words DeVry appear right up here. Now, this is a thing where you can actually look into the viewfinder. You unscrew this and you can actually look out the lens itself for some critical focusing or something that was very, very special. You can look in here and actually peer out through the lens. Now, I don't think this was able to be done while you're filming. I think it was just basically for setting up a shot. Okay, we're going to undo this snap. Undo the snap on the top. Let's move this back here. And we're going to reveal, as long as I don't dump it out of here, the inner workings of this particular movie camera. Now, this one was probably a professional type movie camera, or at least semi-professional anyway, because it had to be really tripod mounted. I don't see really how anybody could hand hold this particular camera and use it. I've loaded it up here with some dummy 35mm film just to show you exactly what this thing looks like. Now, over on this side, it's just really empty. There's nothing in here whatsoever. But this is all the information in here. Serial numbers, even some points where you can oil it. Alrighty, this thing right square in the middle of your picture is the other side of that optical viewfinder. There is a mirror at a 45 degree angle back there, so I could look in from the outside of the camera and look precisely through the lens to do some very exacting focus. And now, as we promised, here's some of those movies from Mr. Bob Spencer.
Principles for which we stand are the principles of fair play and a square deal for every man and every woman in the United States.
When I look around at the resources of the electrical field today, as shown in the...
So, this is Kerry Decker thanking you for your time this time. Until next time, we'll see you again real soon. Good night now.